Racing to the 2024 Kentucky Derby, and this time we go to Gulfstream Park. It's the granddaddy of them all for the three-year-olds on the meet. It is the Grade 1 Florida Derby, and it's all part of a big 14-race card on Saturday, March the 30th. Of course, Gulfstream Park, and they're going to be going a mile and an eighth, and this one's a big one on the Kentucky Derby point scale. 100 points to the winner, 50 points for second, 25 points for third, points all the way down to the fourth and fifth place finishers. We've got an 11-horse field that has been drawn, and remember, the Florida Derby is the all-time leading prep contender for the Kentucky Derby. 25 Florida Derby runners, winners, have gone on to win the Kentucky Derby. That's over the Bluegrass, that does have 23. And in recent years, the Florida Derby does have a lot more winners. Let's take a look at this 11-horse field. Starting off at the rail, we've got Frankie's Empire. 4 career wins. He won the Sewell Stakes. He draws favorably on the inside post. Meanwhile, post position number 2 is Hades, the Holy Bull winner. He's 3-for-3 lifetime, been working out well, won the Holy Bull Stakes. Ballas Out, a maiden winner for Todd Pletcher last time out. That was on the synthetic surface. He is going to try the dirt this time around for trainer Todd Pletcher. Grand Moe the First, out of the Tampa Bay race last time out, enters here in post position number 4. Real Macho, he's got a nice win at Gulfstream Park in an allowance race, a highly rated allowance race. Ran kind of an also-ran race in the Fountain of Youth. Gets a much bigger field and a faster pace this time around for Real Macho. La Dame Bro, going to try to stretch his speed out to a mile and eighth. He was second in the Fountain of Youth to Door Knock. Before that, he ran in the money in the Swale Stakes. Catalytic, a recent winner for Joseph Safi, a maiden winner last out at Gulfstream Park, enters here as horse number 7. Meanwhile, Seminole Chief going for another win at Gulfstream Park, won a stakes race as a 2-year-old, nice winner at Gulfstream Park a few weeks ago. Seminole Chief out of post position number 8. Conquest Warrior, the second favorite on the morning line. 2 straight wins at Gulfstream Park. He broke his maiden, then came back on a Friday and won an allowance race at a mile and an eighth at Gulfstream Park for trainer Shug McGahey. Then you've got Fierceness, the 8-5 morning line favorite. 2-year-old champion. He was 3rd in the Holy Bull Stakes in his first start of 2024. And rounding out the field is Iris's Dream. Turf to dirt. Drew the outside post. Post position number 11. That's going to be a quick run to that first turn, but maybe he can tuck inside and save some ground. That is a look at the 11-horse field. Definitely can make the case for 4 or 5 contenders. You've got Fierceness, the 8-5 morning line favorite. Conquest Warrior going for 3 straight wins. Seminole Chief seems to like Gulfstream Park. Hades is 3-for-3. He's got a 5.5 furlong win, a 7 furlong win, and the Holy Bull win all at Gulfstream Park. Now the top contenders on the betting board, Fierceness is the 8-5 favorite, Conquest Warrior the second favorite. Then I think we're going to see Hades taking some play, an 11-horse field here in the Florida Derby, and your top contenders, Fierceness, Conquest Warrior, and Hades. Now let's take a look at how they got here and see what's shaking out on the front end. You've got Fierceness, the Breeders' Cup Juvenile winner. He was 3rd in the Holy Bull. Here he is in the Holy Bull. He's number 7. He was bumped at the start, then he's wide, and really the first part of this race took a little bit out of him to try to rush up and get in between horses. Fierceness, your 8-5 morning line favorite. Another runner to take a look at is Hades. He's 3-for-3, 3 starts, 3 wins. Here he is winning the Holy Bull. He comes into the stretch even with Fierceness. Fierceness on the outside of him, Hades on the inside in the red. Hades gallops off with the slow fractions and wins the Holy Bull. All 3 of his wins at Gulfstream Park. Meanwhile, you've got Conquest Warrior. He won an allowance win at Gulfstream Park. That was after a maiden win at Gulfstream Park. Here he is drawing off in the allowance race. What I like about this race, it was a small field, not a lot of pace. He was able to hang with the pace runners and then mowed him down late. He won this one. I think he's going to have a presser running style here in the Florida Derby. And his buyer speed figure was an 84 in the allowance race. Here's Conquest Warrior after the race in that allowance race. It's his fourth lifetime start. He ran in New York to start off his career. He's a big frame. I like the looks of him. 17 hands, 1,300 pounds. Conquest Warrior, definitely a top contender. Then we look at Real Macho. Now, Real Macho got a small field in the Fountain of Youth, a lot more horses running here. I think Real Macho can come back. Here he is chasing Born Noble. He's sitting in third. Born Noble was the big favorite in this race, but Real Macho just kept on running, kept on coming after him. I thought this was a nice race. I think Real Macho can improve here in this spot as Real Macho tries to stretch it out to a mile and eighth here in the Florida Derby. Those are a look at some of the contenders. Don't forget about La Dame Bro. Second in the Fountain of Youth, presser running style. The big question for La Dame Bro is the distance. Can he get the 9 furlongs here in the Florida Derby? That is a look at the 11 horse field. Now let's take a look at the pace of the race. I think overall you've got Fierceness. He's going to try to either be on the lead or near that lead with that 10th post position. He's going to have to get out clean break on the gate. And then your pressers, you've got Hades, you've got La Dame Bro. And then I think you might see even Catalytic as a presser or as a mid-pack runner. Conquest Warrior, I think he's capable of sitting 6th, 7th, maybe 5th place. Frankie's Empire drawing that rail. He may have to show a little bit more speed. And then Ballas out, I'm going to put further behind. But an interesting pace. Does Fierceness go? Hades has been on the lead. And then what does Catalytic do along with La Dame Bro? He's stretching out. Does he want to lay a little bit off that pace? That is a look at the pace scenario for the Florida Derby. Big questions as you're handicapping this race. You've got Fierceness, the consistency. He's alternated good starts with bad starts. He's on the form cycle of going back to a good start. He's got a win out of the money. Then he got another win, and then he was third in the last race in the Holy Bull. Speed of the race, the pace, Hades and Fierceness. Which one wants to lead more? Conquest Warrior going up in class, and La Dame Bro going 9 furlongs. Those are some of the questions. My top selection in the whole Florida Derby is going to be Fierceness. I like the way he's been training. 3 solid workouts the last 3 weeks. Came home the final quarter in 23 1/4. Been working out with Tuscan Sky in the morning. I'm going to play him in exactas with Conquest Warrior, and I'm also going to use Seminole Chief and on the bottom half of those exactas with Fierceness. Definitely a strong Florida Derby. We're going to have previews of the UAE Derby this week. Also, we've got the Arkansas Derby coming up. And then April 6th, we've got the Wood Memorial, the Santa Anita Derby, and the Bluegrass all coming around the corner. The Triple Crown Prospectus, sign up below. It's free, 2,000 words every week. And we rank all the top 3-year-olds all the way through the Belmont Stakes and the Saturday Racing Notebook. Florida Derby Day, we're going to have one. Kentucky Derby, Preakness, Belmont Stakes. Make sure to sign up and get entered. If you sign up today, you're good for all of those tip sheets on the big racing days all summer long. Who do you like in the Florida Derby 2024? Do you like Fierceness? Do you like Hades? Do you like Grandmo the First? Leave a comment. The 2024 Florida Derby. Remember, Dwayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.